Hello! The objective of this video is to show you how to handle multiple buttons with Raspberry Pi GPIO, where the buttons involved are competing with each other, controlling the same component, such as a servo motor. Because such situation creates a conflict between the buttons, you need to implement extra measures to prioritize and or selectively block a button so only one of them is active at a time. This example will use two buttons which will move the servo arm slowly in two directions. Let's start with a basic skeleton program. Safety first, it is always very important to take care to provide code that will restore GPIO pins to their default upon program exit when using output components such as a servo motor. This skeleton program handles program exit through Control C key sequence as well as through kill and terminal closing signals. Mechanical devices such as servo motor may also need some time to shut themselves off, and you will see me add some extra code for that later inside the finally block. The project circuit is very simple, just two buttons for left and right direction and a small SG90 servo motor. You can complete this exercise with another servo if you don't have this particular model. The servo is powered and controlled by the Raspberry Pi directly, but you need to make the connections carefully. Typically, such servos use red wires for the plus 5 volts, brown or black for ground, and orange or white for the control signal. This servo may draw up to 0.4 amperes on top of what the Pi itself needs, so make sure that you have a proper power supply. Also, make sure to power the servo from a 5-volt pin, not 3.3. Let's start with the setup. I need three GPIO0 objects, the servo motor and two buttons. While I ultimately want to operate the servo arm slowly while holding the buttons, I need to write some temporary code to calibrate my servo as I just bought it. This can be accomplished through simple button press events that will move the servo arm to its extreme positions. Looks like the servo is operating correctly. It is my experience that depending on the manufacturer, such servo may require slightly different numbers to set it up than what you see in my code. You need to observe the servo during the calibration process, and if it does not move the full 180 degrees, or it is trying to move past it, making buzzing or clicking noises, you need to adjust these numbers slightly up or down until you get satisfactory results. If you see some irregular movement, this is normal. The control signal is soft for PWM and there is a certain amount of jitter. Now that the calibration is complete, I can write the code that I wanted, which will use the buttons to move the servo arm slowly while the buttons are held. This requires a number of changes and additions to the code. First, I need to change the way the buttons are initialized. Button hold event is fired by default after 1 second, and I want to make my buttons more sensitive. I also would like to have the hold event fired repeatedly, similarly to what happens when I hold a key on a PC keyboard. This code will take care of that, and my buttons will fire the hold event repeatedly 100 times per second. The next change is to add the while held events for the buttons with the corresponding callback functions. These functions will be called repeatedly when the buttons will be held, subject to the hold time parameter. The servo arm position is set using the value property, which is a floating number between minus 1 and 1, and I choose to increment it by 0.01, which gives 200 steps of movement across the 180 degree arch. With the held event repeated at 10 milliseconds, the servo arm will take about 2 seconds to travel the 180 degree range under these circumstances. You can adjust both button timings as well as the amount of movement per step to your needs. You can probably see a potential problem with the code so far. This needs to be addressed by a simple condition, which will only allow the movement if the servo is within its allowed range. One last thing to add is the save program exit procedure. I choose to return my servo arm to the middle position, give it a moment to actually get there, and then restore the GPIO pin to the default state by closing the servo. Let's test all that. You can see that the servo arm moves nice and smooth while I hold the buttons. The only remaining issue is that if I press two buttons at once, the servo arm stops moving. By pressing two buttons at once, the servo is continuously receiving conflicting instructions as I fire both the move left and move right events at the same time. This is called a race condition and it needs to be handled. In this case, the correct way to handle this situation is to prioritize the button which has been pressed first. The GPIO0 button has a held time property, and by comparing this value for both buttons, I will always know which button has been pressed first and only perform the movement for that button. An extra if statement in each move function will take care of that. This odd piece of code is necessary, as the held time is an undetermined number unless the button is actually held, and without this, the new if statement check would actually crash. Let's test the updated code. The buttons work as before, but now when I press two buttons at once, the second button is ignored. This is exactly what I wanted. I hope that you found this video useful and will have an opportunity to use this approach in a project. Thanks for watching.